We're just going to do an announcement stream. Okay, I'm just going to wait until I see that we're live on Twitch. And we'll go at it. This is sort of an unannounced live stream. Right after a World Cup game is over. fun day. Only a few games left, handful of games left. Tom, finally, you caught a stream. Yay! How are you doing, brother? Andre, hello. How are you guys doing? This is an unannounced live stream to announce the next three live streams, the scheduled live streams anyway. How are we doing? Should we do? Let's do. I usually don't wait for people to drop by for these unannounced streams. I just go ahead and do my thing. I was just watching your behind the scenes. Ah, cool. I just uploaded that today, right? So that was good. It was a nice discussion afterwards. I like, that's the trend we're going to follow. Valiance, hello. That's the trend we're going to follow. We're going to do streams, live streams. And when I'm recording them, I'm not going to upload the recorded sessions until I edit the recording sessions, upload those, and then upload it behind the scenes. That way, people who are interested in whatever it is that we're covering get the gist of it with the edited video and the better sound quality and everything that needs to be popped up. And if they want to follow up more, they can, you know, take a look at the build-up and the Q&A afterwards. And by the way, if you look at the CTR, hi, from the UK, first time catching a stream, love your, awesome, welcome to our streams. Vanessa, hello, how are you doing? Hey, Zari, how's life? Wow, a lot of people online right now. Hey, Chicho, I was just about to fall asleep to your recent calling on. Hello, Casey, how are you doing? Good sleep sessions. I've been, sometimes I watch my own ASMR videos to fall asleep to, or just to relax. It's sort of, I don't know, I just started, I've been doing that for a while, and all of a sudden it's become a habit of mine to a certain degree, especially comic book hauls, because I like seeing the covers when I show them. I love seeing the covers on the streams. More time for streams now that classes are over. Nice. Same with me. As school's over, I got more time for streams. 100%. But basically, just a point, any behind the scenes video that I'm going to load up after the edited videos are loaded up, I'm going to try to include a table of contents. And I have for the last few, but basically the last one we just uploaded, Let Loose on YouTube and BitChute, it's got a table of contents. If you go in the description of the video, it tells you, you know, how long the meet and greet, you know, the introduction starts. And then it has a section where we do the video shoot and then the Q&A afterwards. So if you already watched the edited video, and if you want to go to the, you know, just a follow up after the shoot, you can definitely go down to the table of contents. Hopefully that will become something that people will recognize, pick up right away, just in case. So because it does contain a little bit of info and people talking and stuff and asking questions and more follow-ups and whatnot, I was wondering what was the big red book behind you, the big red book behind me, big red book. This one is Textbook for Canadian Medical Surgical Nursing. Okay, there's a whole bunch of health related stuff back here related to nursing and the medical system and alternate healthcare herbs and stuff like this all along on this wall. And this wall is mainly comic books, politics, a lot of mathematics and physics, and records. Okay. As far as the announcement goes, the next three live streams, we're going to do, because a lot of people have been asking me to do more politics stuff. Things are pretty intense in the world, and they're going to get more intense. I mentioned, I might give a little intro before this live stream or at the beginning of this live stream, just to let you guys know where I am. So I'll save the intro for that. But basically, On Sunday, ooh, polarization should be good. Also, I think, yeah, it should be interesting, that's for sure. But basically, I've had a lot of people keep on sending me comments or posting comments on YouTube or requests, sending me messages saying, "Look, Chicho, please get back into politics." And I've mentioned I'm gonna get into the realm of politics through economics. I'm a broken record. I keep on repeating myself, right? But I think what's required now, because a lot of people want to know what's going on and how they can, because we need to know politics to be able to manage our lives. We have to. There is no way around it anymore, right? Because there's a lot of shift happening. So I think what we're going to do, just to provide the info or the platform for people to ask questions, once a month or once every 2 months, what do you think of the Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez? I don't, that's not familiar to me. I would have to do a search on it. Alexandria, let me check this out. Alexandria, who is this person? Twitter, I don't know this person. Oh, I saw her picture floating around. What was she getting famous for? It's time for New York that works for all. Oh, the person that got in New York, the socialist that got elected in New York area. I haven't looked into her too much. I just know her. I'm bad with names, so I don't recognize names. I see, recognize more faces and events. I would have to take a look at her platform. I don't know. I don't necessarily follow anyone or support anyone just because they say they're libertarian or they say they're socialist or they say they're anarchist or they say they're left or right, they're this or that. I haven't read enough of her words. Democratic socialist. Anybody that's flying under the Democratic mantle, I would take with a lots of grain, is it grains of salt or sugar, whatever it is. That institution is completely corrupt, as is the Republican, right? They're both completely corrupt. So no matter what, how true they might be to people, like this is, we're already getting into politics discussion. How about we save that for Sunday? Is that cool? What's your take on Trudeau? It seems to me that every time I see news of him, it's bad. I do a little, I talk about this a little bit in the update video that I'm gonna edit today and tomorrow and then upload on Monday, most likely, the live stream that we did a couple of days ago of an update talking about legalization in Canada. Okay, as far as all our Western politicians go, they're all corrupt and they're all in it for, they're not there for the well-being, for the liberty of our societies, of Canadians or Americans or Europeans or British or wherever they are, right? They're in it for the money, right? That's the only thing that governs them, that gets them to do anything, and they're just basically talking heads. Trudeau, there's absolutely no way any leader in the world will have an opinion about everything that happens in that country. It is impossible. I'm well versed in politics, and I don't have an opinion on everything because I haven't done my research and everything. All of our politicians are talking heads. There's a machine behind them pushing an agenda, and that's the agenda we have to look at, right? Unfortunately, she had to run under the number. Well, that's unfortunate, sure. Politics discussion is happening now, just now. I know it's happening now. That's the reason, that's one reason I want to introduce the politics and economics live stream. That way we can answer everybody's questions without the politics creeping into our cooking stuff and our comic book stuff and our mathematics stuff, right? So we need a floodgate, I guess, right? To in case he does this card nice, to deal with the questions, and rightfully so. I've pulled out of it because I'll do a little intro before the politics. Basically, one of my last politics blog posts, write-ups that I did was say that I've said almost everything that I want to say. Nothing has changed, so I'm repeating myself. It was sort of like Arundhati Roy mentioning that she's just repeating herself, and it's a loop, right? So I'd rather tackle our problems and our present predicament through the realm of mathematics and ASMR and sharing information instead of direct head-on with politics, because that's pissing into the wind, I guess. Right? Chicho, Discord has a politics section for anyone wanting to continue this afternoon. For sure, there's a politics section, and we're going to expand on that. I hope to expand the Discord platform that we have a little bit more. Okay, we'll talk about that later once we start rolling some things out. Play a song. Yeah, I'm from Quebec, and the only good thing I heard was the legalization of cannabis coming October. Yeah, sorry, didn't mean to throw you off track. Been meaning to ask you about that. How about we do it on Sunday? On Sunday, maybe I'll get a chance to look into her more. I doubt it. My opinion, if she's flying on the Social Democrat, my opinion of her is basically the same opinion of Sanders, which is a sellout. I don't know if she is. I think Bernie is a major sellout. Like, he threw his support for one of the most corrupt human beings, Americans in the United States, which was Hillary, which was insane. He should have just taken the pill and said, "I step out. The place is corrupt. There's no way it's democratic. Your vote doesn't count." And he should have just stepped out and said, "The hell with them," right? Anyway, we get into politics. I don't want to get into that right now. Sunday, July 8th, 10 a.m. Come with your questions. I'm not gonna have anything prepared on an other than a little introduction at the beginning to have a open discussion. Questions you ask me, we'll do a little research. If I don't know something, maybe like the name, the image will pop up, and I'll know what the discussion is about. Yeah, what Bernie did was upsetting, very upsetting, very upsetting, right? So our first stream is on Sunday, July 8th. Open discussion, politics, economics. For those of you who have politics questions, economics questions, come up. I might have a board behind me, or I might have it on the side where we can draw some stuff and very general, maybe introduce a little bit of mathematics in there. Okay. Since we're doing politics and economics, okay, if you've watched the how to study video number seven, tip number seven, where I showed you my notebook, how I take notes, there was a little bit of note that I took, things that I did for myself regarding a number line. Basically, a number line is really important. I don't care whatever you're talking about, you're always right. Nice. I try to be anyway, chill with it. I've gotten chill in my old age, I guess, right? As my beard, goatee grows white. But basically, in the how to study stream, how to take notes, there was a little section where I showed you, where I took some notes regarding how to put the perspective, the opinions, the debate about abortion on a number line. And one of the things I'm doing is building a fair bit of content for how you can perceive things based on a number line. Because a number line is basically our first step towards the Cartesian coordinate system, right? And people have a hard time visualizing a number line, putting themselves on a scale system. So on Tuesday, July 10th, and in that video of how to study video, tip number seven, where I showed you that stuff, I mentioned that the odds are we were never going to do this, but we're going to do this. Okay. Which is, or we're going to try to do this. I'm going to record it as well. The politics discussion up here. The politics discussion up here is all backwards on the image. Up here, I'm not going to record with the lapel mic. It's just going to be a live stream. And the live stream will be uploaded directly 100% to BitChute, depending on where we go, most likely 95% to YouTube. The Tuesday, July 10th one at 4 p.m. It's ASMR math, but basically it's going to be, let's quantify the abortion debate. Let's put it on a number line. It's mathematics. I'm going to record it on with the HD camera, with the lapel mic, right, the way we're doing it. And then I'm going to edit it. If I like it, I will upload it and then upload the live stream. If I don't like what we capture on the HD camera, how the recording session goes, I probably won't edit it, right? Depending how it plays out. I wasn't planning on doing this, and I'm doing a lot of reading right now, trying to find data that I want to present on a number line that is not based on opinion. It's more based on legality, or I'm not even going to get into the biology of it. I'm going to get into the legality of it, right? And I guess a personal opinion as well to a certain degree. There's a few things I want to put on the number line. Okay. So I'm calling it ASMR math, but it's basically quantifying the abortion debate, and we'll see how that goes. Okay, and that's on Tuesday, July 10th at 4 p.m. I think I can make both of these. Might skip the politics though. Yeah, I should be giving warnings. If you don't wanna, if you like my comic books, the food, the chill stuff and whatnot, I'll try to keep it as chill as possible, but it might not go there. Okay, it might not go there. And the third live stream, a comic book haul. Comic book haul. It's the package has already been sent my way. I have a question, but I'll wait until you do a comic stream. The comic stream is going to be Thursday, okay? The comic book package is on its way to me, right? There's two lots that I bought, okay? They're not complete runs, but they're runs, right? It's a small haul, and then most likely I might put some stuff out on the side that I'm reading, but there's a fair bit of comics there. Don't get me wrong, there's a fair bit of comics there, so it'll take some time looking at the covers. But one of the halls is a Valiant hall, and another one is, I think it's Vertigo. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's Vertigo. I don't think it's Image. It might be Image. I can't remember which publishing company it's from, right? So we're gonna do a comic book haul. As long as it gets to me, it should be here by Tuesday, hopefully. But I'm giving it a couple of days buffer just in case it's delayed. And if the comic book haul doesn't get here by Thursday, I'm gonna hopefully have finished Epic of Gilgamesh by then, maybe, or at least halfway through. I'm loving Epic of Gilgamesh, the first adaptation of Epic of Gilgamesh. So I might give you a review of that, and I'll show you the rest of the comic books, the reader's copies I've been reading, and maybe we'll talk about Batman 50 or whatnot, right? So on Thursday, July 12th, 4 p.m., we're gonna do a comic book stream. Okay, you look like someone that you find on a quest and gives you wisdom and advice and little powers, little magical tokens, right? Off you go on a little quest, go slay some dragons or something, right? I don't know how Chicho can whisper during a politics stream. I wonder if Alex Jones could do it. Alex Jones, jeez Louise, man. Man. Yeah, no, I'm not into yelling anymore. Which is, if most of you most likely know Bob Ross, but one of the things I found about Bob Ross was he used to be a drill sergeant, right? He used to yell and scream at people, and then it started affecting his health. Like, from what I remember reading about his history, it started affecting his health. So what he ended up doing was doing the painting videos, and he promised us himself he would never yell at anyone again. I guess when people's hair go white, they stop yelling. Maybe not true though. A lot of people still yell and scream. I'd quit my quest just to sit around for the next 10 years and listen to talk about whatever. I don't think you want me to talk about whatever. I have some opinions that aren't really well received sometimes. Okay, so those are the next three live streams we're gonna do. They should be fun. And then after this, after these three streams, there's a couple things, some things I've got lined up to do. There are some ASMR math stuff we got lined up to do, and people have been requesting for comic book readings up the yin yang, and I really want to do some comic book readings. And there's some things I need to do with Mermaid Publications, my comic book publishing company that I had in the 1990s, and the comic books through there. So I'm gonna go through some boxes and see where we are. We'll see what comes up after this. I'm sort of doing things as I hit them and putting the events together as as I complete certain things, you know, get them ready to go. And at some point, we're gonna do a cooking stream. I just made rack of lamb. This is my second time trying to make rack of lamb. I made some rack of lamb yesterday, and it came out amazing. It's the best rack of lamb I've ever eaten, really. Okay, and now I love rack of lamb. It's one of the main things I order from restaurants, and this was compatible better than, you know, there might be a couple of other rack of lambs I've eaten in pretty gourmet places that were compatible to what I made yesterday. So I wrote down the recipe real fast because I was winging it, just doing whatever. I usually, when I try to cook something, I sort of wing it until I get it done a few times, and then I write down the recipe or remember to keep on making it. So on one cooking stream, I'm going to show you guys how I made the rack of lamb with the roasted potatoes and yam and squash and stuff. And oh, it was very good. I still have some to eat today, so maybe we do that too. Not next week, but hopefully before the summer is up. Okay. If all politics was stay as relaxed and chill out as Chicho, the world would be a much better place. Hopefully, Discord. Perfect. I'll be driving to Mexico for a bachelor party during your calling call. Looking, love a cooking. I would love a cooking stream too. I just need to get a few things off my plate, especially some of the things I promised to do regarding Mermaid and some of the comic book stuff that I promised to do that I'm way behind schedule. Okay. Hello, Double X. So that's about it, gang. Do you read recent comic books or do you just buy copies for your collection? No, for sure I read recent comic books, 100%. I read a lot of recent comic. Well, I've slowed down a little bit on reading the more recent comic books just because it's summertime. I'm blowing my budget big time, so I've reduced my pull list. But I do read recent comic books for sure. Some of the stuff I'm reading right now is some of the more recent stuff, just on reading list and stuff like this. Some of the stuff, a lot of it is older as well. I'm doing random reads right now because I don't have the time to delve into a series, right? So I'm doing a lot of random reader copy reads, and I'm reading a trade paperback that just recently came out, The Epic of Gilgamesh. But I do read recent stuff, 100%. Not too much Marvel or DC. I was gonna read the Batman stuff, but a year build up and nothing. Just a comment regarding Batman 50 and Batman and Catwoman not getting married. Some people are very, a lot of people are pretty pissed off. A lot of people are saying whatever. But to me, it's basically equivalent like this. It's equivalent to someone constantly saying, putting out their hand for you to just shake their hand, and then they keep on pulling it away, right? And saying, oh, no, I'll shake your hand, I'll shake your hand, I'll shake. And they do this for a year. And after, you know, they tell you at the beginning, a year from now, I'll shake your hand. And you keep on doing it, you keep on doing it. And then after a year, they go, ha 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 ha, didn't shake your hand. It's boring, right? Tom King's stock value has plummeted. Right, dropped a lot of people do not like it, so I'm not going to be reading Batman. I dropped it, and I still haven't read the Red Goblin storyline yet. Oh, they didn't, of course not. Oh, sorry if I gave a spoiler. Spoiler warning: Batman and Catwoman do not get married. It's funny. I was actually going to read it, but I read so many comments about it that I just went, okay, no, let's just put it away for now. There's other things that I'm reading right now that I'm enjoying a lot. So I rather just stick with those. I rather just stick with those, right? As comic books go, collect what you love, read what you love, right? Like Batman 50, I found this out through Vex's live stream. And he mentioned there was 50 variant covers for it. How could you do 50 variant covers for something and not get the job done? To me, it's crazy. Did Kitty Pryde and Colossus get, Kitty and Colossus didn't get married. However, spoiler warning, at least another couple did get married in that, right? Rogue and Gambit got married. At least they had a wedding, right? So not that I'm for weddings. I don't like, to me, the concept of a wedding, being married is weird, right? I don't think anybody really needs the state or a religious institution to, I don't know why people would allow the state or a religious institution to enter their personal lives, right? Other than for the protection, if you, because legally, according to the law, we're getting into politics again, oh my God. According to the law, if you're married, then you have more rights over your children than if you weren't married to a certain degree, right? And you know, most Western governments have passed laws that if you live together for 6 months, that's common law, that's like being married. So that's like them forcing their rules and laws into relationship, which to me is just mind-boggling, right? Just blows me away. They'll make up for it. DC cannot afford to lose Batman. No, they can't. They can't, fans. The more comic streams I catch you doing, the more interested I get. Such an expensive interest to have, though. Yeah, the comic book stuff is expensive. I can't really afford to get into it. You know what? My budget, I've been blowing my budget left and right. Right, I've been blowing my budget left and right. That's one reason. One other thing I've been meaning to do, just since we're on the topic of comic books here, right? I've been meaning to put stuff, some stuff on eBay. People have been asking me what I would do if I was publishing comic books now. I would bypass diamond distributors to a certain degree. I would already introduce, start selling the comic books online, maybe through eBay, your own platform. So I'm gonna take, I don't have very many. I've done multiple moves since I published my comic books, but I'm gonna, because people have been asking where they could get some of my comics that I published, I'm gonna start putting some of those up on eBay. After a few of them go out as a thank you gift, right? So I don't know how many I have, they're limited. I gotta make sure copies get to whoever they need to get to, okay? I'm also most likely gonna go through. Slowly go through my collection just to generate more funds and start putting some stuff up to sell. And I want to go make videos of grading comics. I want to show you guys how I put comics online and sort of look at the stats of it, look at the data of it. And I definitely want to link up that stuff with the comic book hauls that we've done, because what I've been doing with the comic book hauls, you know, one of the reasons we did it because we're going to overlap the stuff with ASMR math, with investing, with economics, right? So I want to take some of those comic books that we've bought in the last, I guess, 3 or 4 years, the ones we've made accounts for, right? And put them up on eBay and sell them to see what price they get, to see if we made money or if we lost money, and start collecting some data and start growing the data set, right? And then start doing analysis on it. So that's long overdue. So I wouldn't mind start doing some of that stuff as well. Okay. God, of course not, Dad. Yeah, try telling my girlfriend that. The social pressures that women feel is enormous. Yeah, huge, huge, huge. It's programming, right? Because it's like, here, I'll give you an example. Okay. We want for an eye. I'm gonna do readings of eye for an eye, 100%, right? Now I'll give you one example since we're talking about social pressures and programming, because marriage is a programming. It's an institutional programming of our society to go through that hoop because it generates money, right? But just to give you an example on that note, right? Because it generates revenue for the government, right? Gives them more money, gives them more control. It's money for lawyers, judges. It's insane, right? But just to give you an example, how governments are dependent on the revenue stream coming in to maintain control over the population, to govern people's lives, which is insane to me, right? Just recently, in the city that I'm in, they mentioned that they're going to increase the taxes on gasoline 1.5 cents more, right? And here's per liter, it's not per gallon like the United States, right? So they're going to increase the taxes on gasoline 1.5 cents more per liter, okay? And the reason for that is because people are driving less, so there's less revenue coming into the government So they need to increase the cost of gasoline to get more money coming into the government, which goes totally against the concept of supply and demand. If there's less people driving, and if less oil gasoline is being consumed, then the prices should come down, right? But they're not, because the government is addicted to that revenue stream coming in. So there's a lot to talk about there in regards to politics and economics. The way things play out, the way people think the way things should play out, don't play out because people don't consider what the economic implications of all that stuff is, right? Why certain rules and laws have been put into place, why there's so much control and so much limitations, so many laws banning us from doing things, right? Because it's a revenue stream for them. Okay. We talked about a lot of things. So much for just being a live stream of an announcement stream, I guess, right? So listen, gang, if you can make it, July 8th, Politics Economics, 10 a.m. July 10th, Tuesday, 4 p.m. ASMR math, and we're gonna put the abortion debate on a number line. We'll try to, okay? And comic book haul on Thursday, July 12th. I'm gonna record both of these ones, okay? I just spent $200 driving to Florida and back a couple of weeks ago. If it were cheaper, I'd drive down there much more. Wow, 200. In the 80s, we used to drive from Vancouver, Canada, to Los Angeles, and it would cost us around $65. Do you use Twitter? Yeah, I use Twitter. I have a Twitter account. I usually do announcements for the live streams on Twitter, and anything I post, I upload to YouTube or post on my Blogspot, I post on Twitter. I don't really get into conversations on Twitter, shouting matches on Twitter and stuff. I don't really like retweet anything. It's just there's a certain amount of time that I have, and I focus that time and energy on YouTube, Twitch, Discord, and whatever it might be, right? I want to send you a picture of my monthly comic haul so you can see what I read. I think, hi, Spamalot, how are you doing? I think, Andre, if you, I forget how Twitter works, if you do at Chicho or hashtag Chicho, I think it sends me, because I've had that happen. Some people mention Chicho and I get a little notice and I click on it and I go to the Twitter thing. It hasn't happened too much, but I know it's happened, but I don't know what the command for it is to make sure that a little notice comes to me to show me what the comic book haul is. Or you could just put it on Twitter and just send me a message through Twitter, I think. I don't know, you can send messages on Twitter. I've been on there for I don't know how long, a long time, but I'm not really, I just make announcements on Twitter. But I'm pretty sure there must be a way just to send me a notice on it. And I'll definitely take a look. I love comic book hauls, right? I love comic book hauls. Man, I've seen some amazing deals go through. I think the price difference between things is huge, right? Between what something sells for and what something, how cheap you can get and how expensive it goes for, right? Depending on just the day. Some stuff goes for a lot, some stuff not. It's interesting. It's interesting stuff. Would love to continue to do this analysis on comic books, investing in comic books. It's fun stuff. Hope you guys are having a fantastic Friday. Hope you have a fantastic weekend. And I'll see you guys Sunday, Tuesday, and or Thursday. Bye for now.